to stop me and to place my feet on sinking sand. Through the pain and all of my sorrows, through the tears and all of my fears, the Lord was there to keep me, for He's kept me in the midst of it all.
Thought I could do it on my own, but All right now. All right.
Help your children. And don't let them fall by the side of the road. And teach them to love.
Safe traveling grace, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, so, God is good, everybody. God is great. For our sake, he gave his only begotten son. In John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believeth in him should have everlasting life. His son lived a life not of his own. His life was lived dedicated to God and the will of mankind.
Amen.
Isaiah 7:14. Therefore the Lord himself shall conceive and bear a son, and he shall be called Emmanuel. God is with us. Amen. Who is Christ, this gift from God? In Acts 8:37, then Philip said, if you believeth with all your heart, you mayest. And he answered and said, I believe it that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, and salvation is yours.
Amen.
All you have to do is believe in what he did on the cross for you.
Oh, yes. Amen.
Between, I'm going to give you a little bit of how Jesus came and how, where he come from. And between the Old and New Testament is a period of time known as the silent years. That's when no direct message from God was delivered to Israel by the prophets. And the book of Malachi was the last the voice the Jews heard from God in an open vision. The book of Malachi closed the old covenant. No more was heard from God until in the open vision. Open vision was the when God openly dealt with the leaders such as Moses and his prophets. Malachi prophesied between the year 400 B.C. and 397 B.C., quite a long time before John the Baptist would appear on the scene in the latter parts of 25 A.D. to claim the new covenant. John was therefore the first voice the Jews heard from God in almost 422 years.
Wow.
God went silent.
Yeah.
John the Baptist was to prepare for the coming of Christ.
Oh, yes. Amen.
Our Savior. And John 3:30 says, he must increase, I must decrease. Jesus made his early appearance into the home of Jewish parents, in the home of the Jewish nation, in the homeland Palestine. Satan knew that all power had been given to Jesus of Nazareth, and therefore he would rise again.
Amen.
The resurrection. What better way for Satan to cause unbelief in the resurrection of Jesus than to cause people to reject the teaching of the resurrection? He died that you might have life.
Amen.
And have it more abundantly.
Yes, yes.
And came forth from the tomb that we might have power to overcome death, hell, and the grave. His power is yours. His Father is our Father.
All right.
Amen.
Only if you knew him as Savior. He is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. John 3:17, for God sent not his Son in the world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved.
My Lord. My Lord.
God is a loving God and wish that no one would perish. And one who loves must also love his brother and sister. John 13:34-35, a new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you. By this shall all men know you are my disciples.
Yes, yes.
And you have love for one another.
Amen.
Come on now.
1 John 4:28 tells us, believe, beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God, and know that he loveth not, know that not God, for God is love. The fruits of the Spirit.
Amen.
The fruits of the Spirit, the first fruit of the Spirit is love.
Come on.
So you must, love is, and the kind of love, agape, bears all things, hopes and all things.
Talk about it. Amen.
Joy. The confident in God that is well, the joy. Peace. A state calm and quiet. Freedom from fear and disturbance. Long suffering, patience, enduring of offensive, of doing of offense, perseverance, gentleness, not harsh, stern, or violent. Gentleness is not arrogant or overbearing.
Right.
Goodness, virtual conformity to standard of right and morality. This is not self-righteousness nor boastfulness. Faith. Matures with every answered prayer. Meekness, controls strength and not weakness. Now the word of the Lord, in Romans 5:8, but God commanded his love toward us, and that which we yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Amen.
Ephesians 4:7. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walketh not after the flesh, but after the Spirit.
Amen. All right.
Amen. The Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Romans 8:28. And we knew that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose.
Yes, yes. Amen. Amen.
John, 1 John 4:7. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God.
Come on now.
For God is love.
Oh, yes.
And this, the love of God, was manifested toward us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into this world, that we might live through him.
Amen.
Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another.
Amen.
No one has seen God at any time. If we love one another, God abides in us, and his love has been perfect in us.
Amen. Amen.
Now, the word of the Lord came. I'm going to go over this Jonah. God came to Jonah, telling him to go to Nineveh, that this great city had cried against, for their wickedness has come up before me, God told Jonah.
Oh, yeah.
But Jonah rose up to flee unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord, all because he knew that the Lord would forgive them, and they repented, and he would change their ways. So the story goes, Jonah got put into the bed of the whale, so Jonah 2:1, Jonah prayed unto the Lord, his God, out of the fish belly, and said, I cry by reason of my affliction unto the Lord. So Jonah repented for his disobedience after 3 days in the belly of the whale. He didn't want to go to Nineveh to save nobody.
Come on.
How many times we don't want to save nobody?
My Lord.
You know, we're supposed to love each other.
Come on.
And no matter what a brother going through, we should be there to help him up.
Amen. That's
to help pick up somebody.
Talk about it.
Now here's the man, a man God said, Go to Nineveh. I want you to go there, tell the people about their wicked ways, and so they can repent, because God wished that no one would perish. Saving God.
Yeah.
He's full of grace and mercy. Now, Jonah, after he gave Jonah 3 days and 3 nights in the bed of the well, Jonah was praying, Lord, no, he didn't like that. He didn't thought, I want to see the light. Can you get me up out of the zone I'm in? I got to see the light. Lord, I promise I'll go. I'll
go down. Come on, Bill. Come on, Bill. Come on, Bill.
He cried out.
Yeah.
You know, when you go through some things, we all been there.
Yeah.
Lord, have mercy on me. Yeah. Look at what I've done to myself.
Yeah.
But if you just let me go this time.
Boy, you better stepping on some toes.
Just give me this one more chance. One more chance. I promise you.
Yeah. Come on. Come on.
He fit John out the belly of the well. And so he was like, okay, now then the voice of the Lord came back to John.
I
want you to go to Nineveh, like I told you. Too bad we had to go around alone.
Okay.
I want you to go to Nineveh.
All right, now.
And do what I say, do for the people to repent of their wicked ways before I destroy their city.
All right now.
Yeah.
Come on, Bill.
So he came because of the Lord. So Jonah repented in this disobedience, and Jonah rose and went to Nineveh according to the word of the Lord. And Jonah began to enter into the city, and he cried and said, yet 40 days and Nineveh shall be overthrown. God told him if they don't get their act together, in 40 days he was going to come in and overthrow the city, the government, everybody involved. Mm-hmm. So people Nineveh proclaim a fast and put on their sackcloth, and you know, they put on this, and greater than them, even the king that put on their sackcloth and cried out. He rose from the throne, and he laid his robe upon him and covered him with a sackcloth and sacked in ashes on the head. That was a way of repentance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
In chapter 4, Jonah 10, and God saw their works, that they had turned from their evil ways, and repented of the evil that he had said, that he would do unto them, and he did not do it. Mm-hmm. But now, that made Jonah real angry. See, Lord, that's why I didn't want to go. That's why I didn't want to go. That you had sent me and that you were going to let them people off the hook. And I just wish you would have just killed them all. And you just went, I knew your forgiveness and your grace and mercy was gonna, you were gonna show it to them. See, I told you, now I just wish that I would die in Paris, son. He got it soaking in his own misery.
Okay, okay.
He made his own self miserable.
Oh, man.
Because God saved them people.
Oh, wow, wow.
I just want to die. So we're going to go to Jonah and finish the story. But God put let me get to it, get it right, because I don't want to make no confusion, but while he was sitting there soaking, God put a leaf over his head so the sun would comfort him.
Yeah.
And so the next day, God stripped it off. He had to wake up and really, Lord, now I really wish I'd die for real. Now you gave it and now you take it away.
No.
I say, see, it ain't fun when I give it and take it away from you. But when you wanted me to do them people in, it was all right.
Yeah.
My mercy falls upon everybody.
Yeah.
I don't just have mercy for you. Yeah. I have mercy for all my creatures.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So in saying that, we must love one another.
Yeah.
The thing is, we can't, when I was growing up, you could say almost anything. You talk to your kids crazy. Oh, you just make me so sick, I can't stand you. Oh, you ugly, this, that. Oh, we can say some things at home that's very, does not very nice.
That's right.
And while you're saying all these things, remember you're scarring your children.
Come on, man.
Yes.
You creating not a good citizen to society.
Yeah.
You must show them love. If they don't get love from home, where they gonna get it from? God love you. He so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son.
Yeah.
And if you believe in him, you shall have everlasting life.
Yeah.
But now we, just like Jonah, we want to cut everybody off. We harder than God. I'm about ready to fight you.
Boy, you better say that. You better say that.
Ooh, Lord, please judge me. I want him to keep this man judging me. I want you to do it, Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Grace and mercy.
God is slow to anger and full of grace and mercy.
Come on, man.
Just think about the times in our lives when, you know, you done fell down and been at your worst moment.
Yeah.
You cried out.
Yeah.
I can recall my worst moment. I cried out, Lord, Lord.
Yeah.
I don't know where to went. I took that left turn in Albuquerque, and boy, where am I at? I'm in the middle of nowhere, Lord. I can't see my way through.
Yeah.
Just, Lord, just put your light back on, because we're in the darkness. Whenever we go out the way, we're in darkness now.
Yeah.
And darn, God is not in the darkness with us. God is the light.
Yeah.
So when you go to the light, that means you're choosing to do right. You're choosing to walk God's ways.
Yes.
You're choosing to be obedient. You're choosing to follow God's way for your life.
Yeah.
Now, I chose I was a fitter welder. My uncle had advice for me on that. Somewhat of a welder. I know you're better like it is. Anyways, so when my tumor, I was sub-arc welding with this company in Texas City. So it was like, I'm going to study at it, and they laid me out about the year. We worked 7/12, and I'm in the recycling business right now. And I was like, first when I was starting to make a transition from a welder fitter to, you know, in this business, my dad, he was like, boys, you crazy. You're gonna go on and change from making this kind of money to, you know, you walking around picking up trash. That's what you're doing. Lord, that's not quite what it is. I know you're going through it tonight, but he was like, that's what you're doing. So I had to really pray about it. I said, Lord, this is what you want me to do. I I'm willing to do it. I don't care what people think about
it. Amen.
It's what you're choosing for me, and I'll accept this job.
Amen.
Because God, if you accept the job that God gives you, you're going to be happy.
Right.
And you're going to be fruitful. You're going to get paid. But some people accept jobs, they're not happy. We can't, don't want to do it. How you going to be a nurse, but you don't like people?
Wow.
I want to be taking care of some people and I don't like them.
Wow.
You know, you want to be in a nurse, a grade and two, go to teacher, but you don't like kids.
Yeah.
You come up, Kurt. I wish I'd never been around. I just wish I didn't have to deal with this every day. No, so now you're praying the Lord to get you out of here. If you choose your occupation and ask the Lord to show you what He wants you to do in your life, not only will you be happy, but you'll be prosperous too. Because with God, He wishes that you will be happy. He's not going to give you an occupation and make you miserable every day.
That's right.
If you're going to work and you see you're miserable every day, change your occupation. Because you're not being productive. You're not helping the people you're dealing with, and you should not help yourself.
That's right.
You're shortening your life up as you do that.
Yeah.
So God will give you direction.
Yes, He will.
All you have to do is want to walk in His way. Walk in His way.
Amen.
Ask the Lord to show. You have to be humble and forgiving. We can't hold grudges against nobody.
That's right.
We can't look up at our brother who we see every day. And boy, I can't stand it. I ain't got to do it. Lord, I wish you. We do that in the church sometimes. Oh, Brother So-and-so, I just can't stand it. Boy, run out that door and jerk your head.
Okay. Tell the truth.
And we have to remember that. We have to pray about that. God, please don't let me have no hatred toward nobody. But let me show forgiveness. And like I said, our children are our future.
That's right. For sure.
So we have to be better leaders.
Yes.
We have to be better leaders.
Yes.
Amen.
We have to be better examples.
Amen.
If our children see us leading the way and we being good stewards of what God has given us, good stewards mean, like if He give you $100, you know how to manage your money, manage your situation.
Yeah.
Some of us are not good stewards of the thing.
That's right.
Quick stuff hit our hand is gone.
Yeah.
You know?
Talk about it.
Quick, and what you're showing your kids is the lifetime of it's gone.
Yes.
Well, mama was gone, daddy was gone. So they reached out, ain't nothing in there.
Mine gone. Yeah.
hey, it's gone. Better manage your money, raise better managing kids, which means that the deficit in debt we live in, America, the great America, is in millions of dollars in debt.
Oh, yeah.
People run around hollering about FEMA. Let me tell you something about FEMA. FEMA writing hot checks.
Yeah, they are.
$15 trillion when it started, and they write $5 more trillion, and $20 trillion in those.
That's right.
So how can you, and you know where that's gonna roll? It's gonna roll down on each and every one of us.
Yeah.
By raised price,
already
higher taxes.
Already.
The government don't pay. They ain't need it for them to say. But we must remember to be better managed and just say no thank you. I know it's hard because we're not used to having that, so it's hard for us to say no thank you. But trust me, if you learn to turn that down, we'll keep prices down, and then we can afford groceries in these stores.
Amen.
That's what we're looking at. But we can't accept everything that's on the table.
Yeah.
Sometimes you gotta say no thank you.
Yeah.
Amen. God is a good God, everybody.
Amen. Amen.
I just want to say it's a great pleasure to see my loved ones in here, my family and friends. And I just want to say we hold on to forgiveness. Amen. Practice forgiveness.
Amen.
Forgive, if you know, sometimes we get all caught up in self-righteousness.
Uh-oh.
You know, we ain't know our kids doing the, we can't shoot them down night and day in their mistake era.
There you go.
We got to remember, hey, we were there once. I can't press my foot on their neck and try to change and make them. We all wish we can keep our kids from going down the same road we went down. That's the biblical philosophy we always use. But I don't want them to go down the road I went down. But they just might.
Yeah.
And it's a chance they will.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But you love it.
Yeah.
This is what it's all about. Love.
Yeah.
This is what this here whole, this is what the whole sermon is about. Love.
Yeah.
Love your children. Love your brother. Love your sister.
Yeah.
Because you don't know, they might be here today and gone tomorrow.
Yeah.
Then you wish you had love.
Tell them.
Then you didn't know. It's amazing how death forgives. Everything is forgiven when somebody dies. They dead is gone. But give me my roses while I'm alive. You want your roses and flowers while you're alive? Tell me how good I was when I'm alive. Tell me how I did a lot to you when I was alive. I don't want to die. Oh, that was a good old boy, that was. What he did so much for everybody, it's just amazing. I love him to death. But you love me till I die. Hey, it's over.
Okay.
I can't feel that.
That's right.
All of the love that you had to offer, I can't feel it no more.
Can't not hear it. It's can't gone. Hear it.
Once you go on the ground, it's all forgotten.
You're up to go.
So that brother took that $20 and never paid you back.
Oh,
it's
no.
I know it's hard. Yeah, it's hard. Give me my money. Give me my money. You know, I can get out of bed, I say, but I have money. We don't care how to do it, small, big, or tall it is.
Oh, my God.
We're going to have a problem, and we might have it forever. Forever is too long.
For $20.
Let that go. Can't leave. You gotta let it go. You have to let it go.
Amen.
Because your brother may have cancer.
Yeah.
Now you're sitting there, you know, bothering. Go comfort him. You sitting over there at your house. Y'all not talking, but you don't know he have a medical condition.
Amen.
That he's dealing with.
Yeah.
Because now y'all too proud, too angry to say, hey, brother, I want to talk to you.
Yeah.
How you doing?
That's right.
Because everybody not promised to be here tomorrow.
That's right.
Yeah, that's right.
You should love while you can love. Reach out to them loved ones. Don't let that be a number in your phone that just you scroll through it. You got 100 numbers, but you only call 2 people. You got 100 numbers. Cousin so-and-so, brother so-and-so, brother. My mama, this no way she ran the people. My mama had a phone. She had a lot of her number in her pocket, sister.
Woo!
She gets so mad when he went to the doctor. I said, mama, answer your phone. I don't want to talk to him. Let's not get caught up in that. I don't know. Because it might be the last time you get to talk.
Mm-hmm.
And then you'll regret it if you did.
Yeah.
It's regrets. Don't live with regrets. Don't live with regrets. Reach out when you leave here and, you know, man, talk to that family member that you really don't speak to. And you've been holding that grudge too long. Much too long. Let go and let God.
Amen.
God can handle all things.
Yeah, he can.
He's the handle of all our problems.
Yes.
He's a problem solver.
Yes,
oh, yeah. And stress reliever.
Amen. Oh, yeah.
If you're stressed, then you're not praying.
No.
You should be praying and letting go and let God handle.
Come on, Bill.
Amen.
Let go and let God have your burden. Yeah.
Come on now.
Cash him. Yeah.
I know he can.
Yeah.
Huh.
I always smile through it. All that road raging people doing out there, if you just They ain't gonna shoot.
He's crazy.
They gonna call you crazy.
Yeah.
Because
you're
sitting there smiling. Like a bobblehead dog. They gonna call you crazy.
Might save your life though.
You got you walk.
Don't entertain.
Yeah,
that's right.
Keep yourself wholesome and pure. But Pastor, I just want to say, if you hadn't been saved, if you hadn't accepted Christ as your Lord and Savior, today is a good day to do it.
All right, now.
Today is a good day
to do it,
right? I accept the fact that your blood has covered me.
Amen.
And I accept the blood of Christ. And I believe that what Christ did on the cross was for me.
Yeah.
That's all you have to do to get salvation.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Acknowledge that.
Yeah.
And all things are possible with God, them that believe.
Yeah.
All right.
With word. Amen. Y'all, that was his first sermon. So if that was good, but y'all better be ready for the next one. Amen. Y'all better be here for the next one. Amen. Awesome, awesome sermon. Bill, that was awesome, man. That was awesome. Awesome word, man. Awesome word. We thank God. Once again, one more time for Minister Bill Walker. One more time. Amen. Now let's hear it for the Holy Spirit. All right. Amen. That's because of the Holy Spirit that Bill Walker was able to preach that word. Let's hear it one more time for the Holy Spirit. Okay. Amen. Hey, I'm in the right place. Amen. I'm in the right place. Amen. 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 And once again, he did the invitation. He did the invitation. Amen. So we thank God for that, because that's a protocol. When you preach the word of God, you have to give an invitation. That's a part of preaching. Amen.
Amen.
It's supposed to be about the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ. Yep. You're supposed to extend an invitation. So awesome job, Mr. Bill. Awesome job. Amen. Church, amen.
Amen.
And I want to thank God for you all being here. The Walker family, amen. I know some of you, amen. It's
amen.
Just awesome that you're here, and we just thank you all for coming and being a part of this first sermon, and we'll see you on the next one. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And for the friends, also for the friends, we thank God for you all also for joining in with us. Amen. Mr. Glenn Warner, amen. He's not a visitor, but it's good to see him also. And just for all of y'all that are here to support Minister Bill Walker, amen. One more time, y'all. One more time. Amen. Amen. Awesome word. Now let's hear for our youth on today. Amen. Awesome job, youth. Awesome job. Amen. Y'all, that's every second Sunday. They come in and they show up and they show out. Amen. Amen. So we just thank God for our youth. Amen. So we just give God the glory, honor, and praise. Amen. This has been such a blessed day. This has been an awesome day. Amen.
Amen.
And for all your visitors, again, we thank you so much for coming out and visit with us. Amen.
Amen.
Don't let this be the last time. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Just want to kind of just again, I want to thank our youth.
Amen.
And this is the last Sunday for some of the kids, teens, are getting ready to leave to go to college. Not only just the college, but school starts tomorrow for our youth and for our teens.
Hallelujah.
We never forget, always, and we do it all every year, to pray for our youth.
Father in heaven, we just want to thank you, Father God. Thank you for this powerful message from Minister Bill Walker, Father God, the first sermon of many. So, Father God, we thank you for those that came to support him, Master. We thank you, Father God, that you are using him in a mighty way. Just not just the minister in the church, but the minister outside the church, Father God. Thank you for the many ministers that we're doing ministry inside and outside, Father God. We thank you, Master. Thank you for all the visitors, the family and friends that came to be a part of this and support it, Father God. We pray that you continue to bless them, Father God. Keep them safe from all hurt, harm, and danger, Father God. We just thank you, Master, and cover and keep them, Master. Father God, we thank you once again for our children, Master. Continue to cover them, Father God, as they leave this place, Father God. Continue to keep an edge of protection around him, Father. And just thank you for all that's happened on today. We thank you, Father God. We give you glory, honor, and praise. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us now, henceforth, and forevermore. Let the church say, amen. Amen. Amen.